Hi there, it's Ina here, and today I want to use this little box to create another one of those assemblage pieces, and I really enjoy putting those together, and I so hope you don't get tired of me showing them to you. So I start with plenty of tacky glue and some simple craft sticks to bring some texture to the back and the sides of this little box. Actually, this is not a real box, it is just the reverse side of a little wall hanging. And you get to see it later on, and they're very inexpensive and easy to find. This one is made out of real wood, which I like, so it makes it very strong. As soon as my wood is placed, and I placed it in many different directions and purposely didn't align it perfectly, I clamp it. I also add some weight on it so it can dry nice and straight. So here it is. And next I will be adding all kinds of bits and bobs. Yes, I purposely collect all this kind of stuff for these type of projects. Some is more organized, some of it lives in a shoebox under my desk. And I found this really fun piece. It comes from an old record player and it moves, so I think it might be a fun addition later on. So I start by adding the first piece. As it is metal and kind of heavy, I use E6000, but for some of the pieces, I continue using the tacky glue. And I decided to add a few more pieces of wood just to give me several levels. Now, gluing all this stuff down is very repetitious. It takes a little while, so I will be jumping ahead a little bit. But no worries, I will give you a detailed look in just a moment. First, I want to add some texture paste to the edges using a gear stencil, and I do so to three sides of the box. And then, of course, all this has to dry thoroughly before I can work with it again. All right, and now everything is dry, so I give you a closer look. As you can see, the box got pretty full with lots of different elements. I made sure to have a good variety, like broken jewelry over here. There's a key, there is a buckle, there's a key you use to wind up toys, and there are more kiddie things like this coin with the skull on it. I also added an old watch, I added a minute hand from a wall clock, there's a die, and lots of gears. There are lots of handyman bits and pieces like screws and nuts. Many pieces, I don't even know what their original use was, but because they looked interesting, I used them, like this little piece down here in the corner. So a lot of it has to do with shape, size, and as long as they're fun to look at, they will complement each other. I also made sure to elevate some pieces by adding little pieces, either a nut or a little game piece underneath it, like I did with this big gear, with the watch, and also with the fish, which, by the way, is also a piece of old jewelry. So that helps it to have different levels and brings more interest into the whole assemblage piece. I also added a chain to the edges, as you can see. And now it's time to cover everything in gesso. And again, I'm forwarding a little bit, because this really takes time. It takes time to get into all the little nooks and crannies, and I think I gave it about 3 coats. And you can still see a little pink because the original color was just really strong, but I don't think it will matter. I also gessoed the little movable part, and I think I go ahead and attach it now because it moves out of the way. I don't think it will interfere with me coloring it or the rest of the box. So I use E6000 for this, and I also clamp it so it will really stay strong and don't come off. Now everything is dry, and I use sprays for starters. Sprays are nice because they can get easily into all the little corners and places which are hard to reach with a paintbrush, and it gives it a nice initial coloring. I use glimmer mist, but you can use anything you have on hand. Even homemade sprays will work. Now, I spray the same color several times just to make it more intense. I dry in between, and just about at this point, my doorbell rang and I got a delivery. It was a perfect timing, I would say. I had ordered this stuff, and you can see it there on the right. It is a rust effect paste, and it's called Rusty, and it's made by Viva Decor. It doesn't create rust, it just makes things look that way. So I was so excited about getting it, and so tried it out immediately. I probably should have tested it out first on something else, but oh well, it all turned out okay in the end. So I added it first to the frame, as you saw, and now to the inside. Now, by this time, my brush has a lot less of the paste on it. I'm also more careful and just touching up edges and certain areas. Also, combined with the colors I'd already sprayed into the box, it really makes a nice effect. I was really positively surprised how cool it looks, and I really like it. But I think you need to use it very sparingly, and I think I way overdid on the frame. And somewhere here, I realized that the frame is gonna look way too orange. So I took my baby wipes and took quite a bit of it off again. And in the end, you'll see it all works out okay. So, anyway, this is a new medium for me. It's always fun to work with something new. And you see me continuing with it and with more sprays and also with my metallic acrylic paints I always use. Again, I use those with my dry brush just for different effects. Here's a little copper. Then I use a little bit of off-white. I use more sprays, and it kind of goes back and forth quite a few times. And that's the way it is with these pieces. It's just playing and having a fun time bringing out the colors until I'm happy with the final result, and that can take a little while. Next, I use some metallic rub-ons to bring out the texture on the rims, so I can see those gears a little bit better. And that's pretty much the last step in coloring this project, but I want to add one more thing to it. I found a cute little metal owl in a local craft store. I think it's meant to be used for making jewelry, and I want to add him to the end of this moving arm. Earlier, I had added a big gear to the end of it to make it easier for this owl to fit. So he also gets a little bit of my rust treatment, a little metallic rub. I clean his eyes, and he's ready to live on his little perch here. He needs to dry, of course. And now everything is completed, and I will give you a last look. Now, this is definitely very steampunkish and rustic and rusty looking. I love these colors, and in reality, they are quite a bit brighter than my video camera here picks up. You can see that later on in the photos. Now, thank you so much for coming and watching me make yet another one of these assemblage pieces. I know it won't be my last. I just really enjoy putting these together. And there is my little owl flying around in his steampunk box. I hope this gave you some good ideas. I hope it was enjoyable for you. See you really soon again. Bye bye for now.